Leslie Marsh, and I am a museum educator, critter caretaker for Creative Discovery Museum. And I have with me some Madagascar hissing cockroaches. And the one in my hand is a female. She's a little roach. And
how can you tell?
Well, I tell you what, you can tell that it has barely noticeable bumps on top of its head.
So the male has bumps and the female doesn't have bumps?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
And the females also have more of a slender bodies and dark in colors. As you can tell, this one is sort of a maroon, a little beige. And the males are mostly brownish beige.
So. Do you have a male in there?
Yes, I do. I have a male, and can you reach that? All right. I have a male on the side right there, and you can tell the difference between the female and the male. Yeah. And then we have a baby.
He's much lighter.
Yeah. So, yeah.
A baby?
Much lighter. Yeah,
this one?
There's a little baby there. So you could tell that it is definitely much smaller. They can get pretty big.
So is that one full grown?
No, it's probably about a year and a half. They can be up to 3 years.
They'll live 3 years?
Mm-hmm. They can, yes.
And where is Madagascar?
Madagascar is the island off the east coast of Africa.
So where did you get this Madagascar hissing cockroach? From a pet store or?
That I don't know. I don't normally see Madagascar hissing cockroaches in the pet stores.
And why do they call them hissing cockroaches?
They are hissing cockroaches because they make hissing sounds for various reasons. To communicate with each other, they can do like a happy hiss, a what's on my back hiss. And they also use this for courtship. So, yes.
They have a hissing song for courtship?
Yeah, they have a hissing song and touching each other. The males butt each other like rams. They will hit each other for mating rights. Uh-huh. And whoever wins will go to the females and they'll hiss and they'll stroke with their antennas on the females' bodies.
Okay. So do they have live babies or do they lay eggs?
No, they give birth to live babies. They do.
But they're not mammals, right?
They're not mammals. They are insects. But one of the few insects in the whole insect kingdom that give birth to live babies. Mm. It could be anywhere from 5 all the way up to 50, maybe more. When they're born, they are completely white. Completely white. And then when they molt, which means they grow from the outside, it's like a zipper jacket down in the back, and they open up.
The exoskeleton?
And that's how they grow. Yes, the exoskeleton. So they grow from the outside. And when they do, they are white, completely white, for about 24, 48 hours. Depending on their sex, they'll turn to those colors. Like the females are darker colors, the males are more of a lightish brown colors.
So what do they eat?
What do they eat? They eat just about anything. They can eat fruits, vegetables. Right now I got sweet potatoes and I'm getting ready to put some lettuce and celery and carrots in there. So they can eat just about anything.
That's what you feed them is just fruits and vegetables?
Fruits and vegetables, yes.
Is that like protein? Is that where they're getting their
protein? And the sweet potatoes, they get the minerals. Mm-hmm. And then, of course, the darker the greens are, the more nutrient value they have. But they like to, like us, they like to have celery and some of the lighter lettuce. And they just like a treat for them, like ice cream is a treat for us. They do not drink from a bowl, because if they do, they can easily drown. We want that. Mm-hmm. So we have a test tube filled with 2 cotton balls. And we put the cotton balls in there and make sure, you know, it doesn't leak out.
So there's water in the tube?
There's water in the tube.
Oh, I gotcha.
Yeah.
So why do Madagascar hissing cockroaches make good pets?
They're very gentle. They do not bite. So they're very easy to care for.
Very cool. What do you like about Madagascar hissing cockroaches?
I like them for a couple of reasons. As I mentioned, they are gentle. They do not bite. They're actually one of our animals that kids and adults alike can come and pet them. I help them out.
People don't think very highly of cockroaches. Yeah. They're kind of a pest. Are they a pest in Madagascar?
Not really. They actually help with the fruit, you know, the bushes and the trees. They eat decaying matter and just about anything I mentioned.
An important part of the ecosystem. Yeah,
they could put nutrients in the soil and help them grow, because there are some areas in Madagascar that are very arid and dry. And we want the roaches to be present to help with the growth over there.
Well, thank you very much for sharing the cockroach with us.
Oh, you're welcome. Thank you. Well, I'm Leslie Marsh, and I'm a museum educator and pet caretaker. And I would love for y'all to come to the Creative Discovery Museum and visit my Madagascar hissing cockroach.